When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through you? Well, we're giving them to you. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street, USA.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzels with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad. Go! With blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel.
Hello, this is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, here on WPPB 88.3 FM, Peconic Public Broadcasting, radiating out of the lovely and today very sunny hamlet of Southampton, New York. Well, if you were to ask me what were some of my favorite things, I would certainly have to say Tony Bennett, the music of Rodgers and Hammerstein, and maybe best of all, the chance to host this radio show, Broadway to Main Street. And today, listeners, fans, is the 100th original episode of Broadway to Main Street. That's right, we've done 100 original episodes since January of 2012. And today I thought I would celebrate some of my favorite things, songs that I've loved from Broadway, oddities, rarities, some mainstream songs, but songs that have touched me in some way and songs that I enjoy sharing with you, because that is the greatest part of this particular job, is getting a chance to share with our listeners the kind of music that makes me dance and sing and jump around, as Bob Merrill and Julie Stein sort of said. Let us go back to the beginning. I remember my very first Broadway, quote-unquote, album was a record I used to ask my parents to put on called The Man with the Coffee. And that's at least what I called it, because there was a man with a cup of coffee. Of course, it was not coffee at all, but tea. And that man was Noel Coward. And the album was Noel Coward in New York, which was a wonderful apex of his cabaret years in the 50s. This was recorded in the early 60s with great jazz backup by Peter Matz. And a lot of people love Noel Coward for his witty patter songs, but his ballads and his romantic songs were equally moving. Here is one I loved particularly as a child, and I still do, Sail Away, written and performed by Noel Coward.
When the storm clouds are riding through a winter sky, sail away, sail away. When the love light is fading in your sweetheart's eye, sail away, sail away. When you feel your song is orchestrated wrong, why should you prolong your stay? When the wind and the weather blow your dream sky high, sail away, sail away, sail away. When a sailor goes to sea, though he leaves his love behind, time and tide will set him free from the grief inside him. Sea and sky will ease his heart, regulate his troubled mind. Every sailor has a chart and a star to guide him home. When your life seems too difficult to rise above, sail away, sail away. When your heart feels as dreary as a worn-out glove, sail away, sail away. But when soon or late you recognize your fate, that will be your great, great day. On the wings of the morning, with your own true love, sail away, sail away, sail away.
The artistry of Noel Coward is both performer and composer. This is Larry Maslon. Today we're celebrating our 100th original broadcast with some of my favorite things. Well, that may have been the first album I listened to as a child, but the first show I saw as a child, I'll never forget, it was 1776. Not in 1776, but in 1969, from the rear balcony of the 46th Street Theater with the original company, William Daniels, never forget him. One of my favorite performances ever, Howard Da Silva and Ken Howard as our founding fathers. Well, here is a number from the second act of 1776. It was actually written out of town in New Haven during a blizzard after they pulled an entire 20-minute sequence out and substituted it with this instead, and supposedly it was inspired by the wonderful poster. At any rate, the show and the song inspired me as a youngster. One of my favorite things, The Egg from 1776.
It's a masterpiece, I say. They will cheer every word, every letter.
I wish I felt that way. I believe I can put it better. Now then, attend as friend to friend, our declaration committee. For us, I see immortality in Philadelphia City. A farmer, a lawyer, and a sage, a bit gouty in the leg. You know it's quite bizarre to think that here we are, plain midwives to an egg.
Egg? What egg?
America, the birth of a new nation.
We're waiting for the chirp, chirp, chirp of an eaglet being born, waiting for the chirp, chirp, chirp on this humid Monday morning in this country.
congressional incubator.
God knows the temperature's hot enough to hatch a stone, let alone an egg.
We're waiting for the scratch, scratch, scratch of that tiny little fellow, waiting for the egg to hatch on this humid Monday morning in this congressional incubator.
God knows the temperature's hot enough to hatch a stone, but will it hatch an egg? The eagle's going to crack the shell of the egg that England laid.
Yes, sir, we can tell, tell, tell on this humid Monday morning in this congressional incubator.
And just as Tom here has written, though the shell may belong to Great Britain, the eagle inside belongs to us.
And just as Tom here has written, we say to hell with Great Britain, the eagle inside belongs to us.
From 1776, the first musical I ever saw. This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street. And today we are taking that road backwards into the dark, backward abysm of time, as Shakespeare said, to look at some of my favorite things. We're celebrating our 100th episode. Richard Rodgers has always been incredibly important to me, both as a listener and a historian and a lover of Broadway music. The first real professional assignment I had of any consequence was to write the American Masters documentary on Richard Rodgers called The Sweetest Sounds, based on a lyric he wrote. And I've written three books about music by Richard Rodgers, and I eternally listen to him and always come back to him. So let's take a little trip down Richard Rodgers Lane. Let's go to Rodgers and Hart. On this show, I've often played not just the original cast album, but I think wonderful performers from jazz and pop world who I think have innervated and ennobled this kind of music. Here's one of the greatest, and a song with a lyric that still knocks me out every time I hear it. Here is Sarah Vaughan singing Rodgers and Hart's A Ship Without a Sail.
Somehow that's just the way it is, and I don't really care. I go to this or that place, I see. I'm alone,
If anybody transports me across the ocean, it's Sarah Vaughan. And what about that lyric by Larry Hart? My head is just a hat place. Oh, the best ever. Well, we're going to continue with some Richard Rodgers, this time with Rodgers and Hammerstein, some of my favorite things, aptly. And quick shout out to my friends at the Rodgers and Hammerstein organization who've been so supportive of the show and have given us a generous grant last year. Ted Chapin, Bert Fink, Bruce Pomahack. Here's to it, gentlemen. And I will take you to a Richard Rodgers show that I like very much, which doesn't get much play, which is called Me and Juliet, a 1953 show that was a contemporary backstage musical, which you wouldn't think those guys would write, but they did, and I think they wrote it very well. Here is a wonderfully jazzy opening number. I think, I could be wrong, the piano in this cut is played by the estimable Barbara Carroll. But here is Isabel Bigley to sing That's the Way It Happens from Me and Juliet.
You're a girl from Chicago on the road with a show. Not a soul in New Haven you can say you know. You wish you were a mile or so from Michigan Lake, home with your mother and a T-bone steak. Then along comes a fellow with a smile like a kid, and he gets your attention with a timely bid. He says he knows a bistro where they give you a break with French fried potatoes and a T-bone steak. You were shy and uncertain, but he pleads and you yield, and you don't have an inkling that you're signed and sealed. By merely telling someone you'd be glad to partake of French fried potatoes and a T-bone steak. That's the way it happens. That's the way it happens.
In New Haven on the road with a show. There's a girl in the company that you hardly know. You watch her and you wonder if she'd like to partake of French fried potatoes and a T-bone steak. Then along comes a fellow who is quicker than you, and he does what you thought that you would like to do. He takes her to a bistro where they give you a break with French fried potatoes and a T-bone steak. Now you see them together and you know in your heart that you lost what you wanted at the very start, because you didn't ask her if she'd like to partake of French fried potatoes and a T-bone steak. That's the way it happens. That's the way it happens. That's the way it happens.
washing the ale of night, while your flower boat sail away. Gently your eyes looked back on mine, clearly you heard me say, you are the girl I will love someday.
Wow, well, if there was ever a song that deserved the title Beautiful, to me, it's that track from Flower Drum Song by Rodgers and Hammerstein. The big shows by Rodgers and Hammerstein, you all know, Carousel, Oklahoma, South Pacific, and so on. I love those shows. I admire them greatly. But actually, if you were to ask me what my favorite score by Rodgers and Hammerstein would be, it would be Flower Drum Song. I think that song is so surpassingly beautiful. And the whole score is full of interesting change-ups and left turns and right turns. And we'll devote a whole show to that someday. But today, this is Larry Mazon, your host for Broadway to Main Street. We are celebrating our 100th original episode by playing some of my favorite things. And this is time to give a shout out, as the kids, the youngsters say, to the wonderful staff here at WPPB, our executive in chief, Wally Smith, who had the faith in me to put the show on the air 2 years ago, Bonnie Grice, who's always been a great supporter and helped me with the pilot episode. And double hats doffed to Kyle Lynch, our wonderful engineer who makes each of these episodes seamless and wonderful and exciting. So, we also have a surprise to announce at the end of the show. I won't tell you what it is quite yet, but if anyone could deduce what a surprise might be, it would be our next character, Sherlock Holmes, embodied by Fritz Weaver from the 1965 musical Baker Street. This is one of the first shows I ever listened to because I loved Sherlock Holmes. I never saw the show, but I was lucky enough to write the liner notes and to get Decca Broadway to re-release it on CD. So here is Sherlock Holmes himself, played by Fritz Weaver, telling Irene Adler about the way he sees the world.
You, of course, do not believe in love, Mr. Holmes.
My dear Miss Adler, I have waited in vain for someone to explain what love conceivably can offer the cerebral type of man. But no one ever has, and no one ever will, for no one ever can. But the cold, clear world of the intellect is the world that I revere. In the pure, dry air of the scientist, I am in my proper sphere to illumine what was dark with a spark of cerebral electricity. There's felicity from a fragment to construct the comprehensive whole. There's nectar for the soul from the thick black cloak of a mystery to deduce the why and how. Just a loaf of bread and a cryptogram, this were paradise enow. With the power of the mind to find what a foe has concealed with devilish care, there's joy, there's happiness, and to spare. I have waited in vain for someone to explain what love conceivably can offer the cerebral type of man. But no one ever has, and no one ever will, for no one ever can.
That was Fritz Weaver as Sherlock Holmes in Baker Street, one of the earliest cast albums I ever loved. I was always into adaptations when I loved the musical theater. I always would find a source material that I loved and wondered, how did they do that? How did they turn that into a musical? And perhaps the one that always fascinated me the most was the 1973 adaptation of Cyrano de Bergerac starring Christopher Plummer in a Tony-winning performance. I never got to see it. Closed after 49 performances, but they released a wonderful double album, which I went through two copies of, and I was lucky enough to write the liner notes for its CD release. So here is one of my most cherished albums of all time, Christopher Plummer and Lee Beery singing about what childhood was like in Bergerac.
Remember when the two of us were saplings in the sun?
Contented then, the two of us, before we knew what life could do.
To wonder world of summer childhood, blue and golden green, when you led your leaden army,
fighting for my queen, in my paper helmet, a real royal rose, upon the track. In Bergerac,
up here some frightful foes.
Golden fanfares in the sunrise, shrilling through the sky.
Silver oboes hailed the moonrise when the owls would cry.
Nectar in the roses
and honey in the air.
We knew no lack in Bergerac
of anything,
for everything was there.
Kittens and catkins and cockle shells and cakes. Songs from the servants were most obscure.
Most impure.
Peacocks strutting on the terrace.
Ah, insolent as lords.
Reeds and rushes from the river.
Sharply pointed swords.
Many were the dragons and giants that you slew.
I'd have a crack in Bergerac.
At anything.
At anything.
At anything.
For you.
Custard and curtsy.
And juvenile panache.
Sea swarms and rainstorms.
My ink moustache.
My nettle rash. I would try to teach you dancing.
Underneath my moon.
How you grumbled as you stumbled through a rigadoon.
Smirking like a courtier and treading on my toes. I got the knack in Bergerac of everything. Of everything. Of everything but moon. Lizards on the wall.
Walnuts and blueberries.
Meadow sweet adorned your feet. Lost along receding highways. Innocence and joy.
Who can trace the buried byways of a girl and boy?
But listening to linnets.
When lilac chokes the air.
I'm taken back to Bergerac. Especially,
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 especially when you were there.
The charms of an underrated musical. Cyrano, starring Christopher Plummer. Well, listeners, this is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on WPPB 88.3 FM, and we are celebrating our 100th episode of this show with some of my favorite things and a little surprise. I first want to thank some of our local listeners, Ellen. I don't know your last name, Ellen, but you've always been a great fan. And Joe Sullivan Lesser, the great original Rosabella from Most Happy Fella. That rhymes, who has supported our program. Thank you very much, and keep those supports coming. Well, our surprise is on Monday morning, Monday the 14th, at 8 a.m., we are going to debut the Broadway to Main Street website. That's broadwaytomainstreet.com. And we will have an archive of all 100 episodes for you to listen to, and we'll update them every week. So keep listening to that. And keep listening to one of my favorite performers, Keith Michelle, a great West End singer with an incredible amount of charm. I love playing obscure West End musicals. This is from Robert and Elizabeth, a show that never made it to America for reasons too complicated to go into. But listen to the song and tell me if you don't think it's fantastic and deserves to be seen on a stage sometime. Here is Keith Michelle from Robert and Elizabeth.
Bad news, sir?
Bad news. You've just brought me the most superlatively good news since the dove brought the first green leaf to Noah.
Five. What's that, Mr. Browning, sir?
She's invited me to tea.
Ah, that's nice.
Nice. Man, the heavens have opened. Tell the sky. I carry the moon in my pocket. Down came the moon like a rocket and plummeted into my pocket. The morning sun, I must have forgotten to lock it. I carry the moon in my pocket and the lightning is shining with stars. Depressed was I when suddenly out of the blue came glittering crescent and new came a luminous letter from you came. Now hope soars high and nothing can possibly stop it. I carry the moon in my pocket and my jacket is Venus and Mars. Trumpets ring out, come choristers sing out. Every bold, bright banner and flag be unfurled. The moon and I are treading a heavenly highway. So anyone traveling my way, all's right with the world. I carry the moon, a magical moon, a marvelous moon in my pocket. A magical moon, a mellifluous tune, and all's right with the world.
You carry the moon. A magical moon, a marvelous moon in your pocket. A magical moon, a catch of a tune, and all's right for the world. Tell the sky, you carry the moon in your pocket. Dark in the moon like a rocket, and plummet it into your pocket. The morning sun, you must have forgotten to lock it. You carry the moon in your pocket, and the lightning is shining with stars.
Lightning, thunder, the earth is a wonder. See where every valley and hill is to pearl. The Milky Way has added a carpet of glory. The finishing touch to the story is all's right with the world. The finishing touch, the delicate touch, the twist in the wrist of the story. The ultimate touch is certainly such that all's right with the world. Man, crescendo, come walk us a blend. Oh, let your clearing ears message be heard. Proclaim to all the moon is as light as a feather. When you and your lover together, all's right with the world. The moon is as light, the moon is as light, the moon is as light as a feather. It comes from above with a symbol of love. It comes from above with its message of love. It comes from above, and when you're in love, all's right, all's right, all's right with the world. All's right with the world.
Lights are bright, pianos making music all the night, and they pour champagne just like it was rain. It's a sight to see, but I wonder what became of me. Crowds go by, that merry-making laughter in their eyes. And the laughter's fine, but I wonder what became of mine. Life's sweet as honey, and yet it's funny. I get a feeling that I It's like, well, maybe it's like a baby sees a bubble burst before its eyes. I've had my flame. I've been around and seen most everything, but I can't begin. It's the same champagne, it's a sight to see, but I wonder what became of me.
Was Chris Connor, one of my favorite singers, singing one of my favorite songs from one of my favorite shows, St. Louis Woman, an incredible song by Arlen and Mercer that was cut from the show. And St. Louis Woman is the kind of show where even the cut songs are better than the lead songs in most shows. We will turn now in our 100th episode, celebrating my favorite things, to one of my favorite shows, which you all know, probably my favorite singer, Sammy Davis. This was from the original album of Golden Boy, and he recorded it, I guess, a few days after it opened. He smoked 3 packs a day. He gets through it, I think, in a really interesting and original and dramatic way. But he went back, I don't know, 2 years after and re-recorded this track. But here is the original track from the original album of Golden Boy, Sammy Davis and Paula Wayne singing I Wanna Be With You.
Somehow it sounds so right. Somehow you feel what I feel too. I wanna be with you. I wanna be with you. I wanna be with you. After all the nights of wanting you, lying there loving you, hating you, tonight I'm touching you, tasting you, world, you're gonna see. We'll make out somehow. Here's my girl and me. They can't hurt us now. Here's our chance, it's not too late for us. Grab it fast or life won't wait for us. I wanna be with you.
from the Titanic score of Golden Boy. This is Larry Maslon celebrating our 100th episode of Broadway to Main Street with some of my favorite things. Let me give a quick shout out to some of my favorite fans, Matt Sussman, Will Friedwald, Andy Zerman, Charles Koppelman, and way across the ocean, Lisa Halliday. Thanks for your support, folks. It means a lot to be able to come and do this show, and I know you have the wind behind my back. Well, I'm sure you're all saying, okay, where's the Sondheim? You can't have a My Favorite Things without the Sondheim. A lot to choose from, but for me, my favorite song by Sondheim, or certainly one or two of them, actually happens to be his favorite song, so that shows you how smart I am, or how smart he is, that we both agree. From Pacific Overtures, 1976, the original cast album performance of an amazing song. Listen to it and see if you're not thrilled. Someone in a Tree.
Pardon me, I was there.
You were where?
At the treaty house.
At the treaty
there
house.
Was a tree.
Which was where?
Very near.
Over here.
Maybe over there, but there were trees then everywhere. May I show you there
if
were
you
trees
please.
Then everywhere.
But you were there.
And I was there. Let me show you.
If you please.
I was younger then. I was good at climbing trees. I was younger then. I saw everything. I was hidden all the time. It was easier to climb. I was younger then. I saw everything. Where they came and where they went. I was part of the event. I was someone in the tree. I was younger then.
Tell him what I see.
I am in a tree. I am 10. I am in a tree.
I was younger then.
In between the eaves I can see. Tell me what I see. I was only 10.
I see men and matting. Some are old, some chatting.
If it happened, I was there.
I saw everything.
I was someone in the tree.
Tell him what I see.
Some of them have gold on their coats.
One of them has gold. He was younger then.
Someone crawls around passing notes.
Someone very old.
He was only 10.
And there's someone in a tree.
For the day is incomplete.
Without someone in a tree, nothing happened here.
I am hiding in a tree.
I'm a fragment of the day.
If I weren't used to say, things would happen in the way that they happened here.
It's the
pebble,
not the day.
It's the pebble, not the stream.
It's the ripple, not the sea. Not the building, but the beam. Not the garden, but the stone. Not the treaty house.
Someone in a tree.
Pardon me, I am here, if you please, I am also
they
here.
They kept drinking cups of tea.
They kept sitting on the floor.
They drank many cups of tea. No, we told him that before.
If you please, I am here.
You are where?
In the treaty house.
The treaty
or
house.
Very near.
Can you hear?
I'm below.
So I
underneath
know
the floor, and so I can't see anything. I can hear them, but I can't see anything.
But you can hear.
But I can hear.
shall I listen?
If you please.
I can hear them now. I shall try to shift my knees. I can hear them now. I hear everything. I'm the part that's underneath. With my sword inside my sheath, I can hear them now. One is over me. If they knock, then I appear. I'm a part of what I hear. I'm the fragment underneath. I can hear them now.
Tell us what you hear.
First I hear a creak and a thump. Now I hear a clink. Then they talk a bit. Many times they shout when they speak. Other times they think or they argue it. I hear floorboards groaning. Angry growls. Much droning. Since I hear them, they are there. As they argue it, I'm the listener underneath.
Someone reads a list from a box.
Someone talks of laws. Then they fan a bit.
Someone bangs a fist.
Someone knocks. Now there was a pause.
Then they argue it.
But we want, no you can't, and we won't, but we need it. And we want, will you grant, if you don't, we concede it.
I can see
it. The night, and they lit yellow tears.
I was there.
If I were to say, things would happen is the same that there happened to me. It's the fragment of the day. It's the pebble.
This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street. I'm someone on a mic, and I'm happy to be part of Broadway history. Sharing with you today our 100th episode. It's just been such a joy sharing all this material with you. As I said earlier, our big surprise is we are launching its own Broadway to Main Street website Monday morning at 8 a.m., Broadway2MainStreet.com, and we have all 100 episodes, archives, stories, links to books and articles and all sorts of stuff I think you'll enjoy. And if you want to write to me, you can do that at Lawrence, L-A-U-R-E-N-C-E, at Broadway2MainStreet.com. So let's keep the conversation going. And I'm thrilled to provide this legacy of great American music to you. And someone once asked me, or they often ask me, what's my favorite musical? Well, the one that was most fun for me was On the 20th Century. I saw it in Boston. I loved it. Never forget it. And here at the end is John Cullum as Oscar Jaffe, giving his legacy to his colleagues. So this is my legacy to you, Broadway to Main Street, and I hope we'll not listen to another 100 broadcasts, but another 1,000. Thanks, everybody. And here is John Cullum to take us out.
You may feel bad for a while, but it's better far this way, for I am much too good a showman to dwindle like a snowman melting down one sunny day. My office once overflowed with celebrities galore. I rule
way like a king. But now what lies in store? Oh, boys, can't you see it? Oh, God, I can see a lonely shuffling figure haunting Schubert Alley. It's Crazy Oscar, hear them cry. Get Officer O'Malley. I meant no harm. Please help me up. Where are my pencils? Where my cup? Oh, thank you, lad. I'll move along. Pencils! Pencils! Who'll buy my pencils? Crazy Oscar's song. You wouldn't want to see me that way. Boys, I know when I've had my day. My story ends. The drama's through. I leave my worldly possessions to you. To you I leave my cape and my fedora. To you I leave my mustache wax. To you I leave an ostrich fan from Floridora. To you I leave my unpaid income tax. To you I leave my bust of Henry Irving. To you I leave my headache pills. To you my set of Theodore Dreiser, my portrait of the Kaiser, and a 10-foot stack of unpaid bills. And when you hear a lonely whistle blowing some future time while riding through the night, could be that whistle is your dear departed Oscar calling. Boys, let's meet at Luke's house for a bite. To you I leave my Japanese kimono. To you I leave my cane and spats. To you I leave a worn-out record of Ramona. To you I leave my gravy-stained cravat. To you I leave my letters to the critics. To you I leave a large false nose. To you my bowl of red wax cherries, a wig of Ellen Terry's, and some ticket stubs from Amy's Irish Rose. Boys, dry your eyes. I don't want to see you weeping. I want smiles and pride in the memories of your association with me. And someday, in the future, when you're feeling low, I want you to go to your closet. And when you open that closet door, take out my cape and take out my fedora and put them on and think of me. And call to mind my charismatic aura and the legacy I left to him.
Well, where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some other time.